there are 51 records which have this specific year value. So once we know this, we can go to the spreadsheet and prepare some sort of filtering so that the same flag applies to all the records that show years. And some of the more advanced capabilities of the spreadsheet are the use of formula and the use of scripts, advanced scripting. This requires some programming skills, but that's the most efficient way, once you know how to program it, the most efficient and fast way to do all this stuff. We could, for example, prepare a script that takes the coordinates, prepares a query to an external database, return the country value, compare the extracted country value with the country in our data set, see if they match. If they match, then don't do anything else. If they don't match, then flat. Everything with a single step, with a single script. This is why spreadsheets are a good way of flagging errors. So, to sum up, error flagging is the process reporting issues without modifying the original data, because we're not allowed to do so, because it won't be efficient to do so. So error flagging is useful when working with shared data. And in spreadsheets, which are a simple way of matching data, but still they're very powerful, error flagging can take several different levels of difficulty, depending on what we want to do. And there are several lots of possibilities filter and flag